It's a joyous day to be aware of my Lord, of my Savior, Jesus Christ. I smile when I call his name, Jesus Christ. It's a joyous day to be aware of the presence of my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ. For I worship him in spirit and in truth. Because I see Jesus as being the original man. And I see the original man returning in many senses, in the spirit, in the minds of many men and many women. I see the original man in spirit returning in the minds of many men and many women. I hear it as they speak the gospel and the gospel truth into the atmosphere every day and every night. It's a great feeling to wake up and turn my radio on, or turn my TV on, or pick up a magazine, or hear in a newspaper about the gospel truth, the original man. For he comes in spirit, and he comes in truth. Many men have taken up their cross and began to walk with it. They began walking as babies. And some of them have grown up to become the sons of man. They began walking as babies, and some have grown up to become the sons of man. Well, we can walk in spirit and truth, and still be a child in the spirit of God, for we don't know enough to become a man yet. But we are still crawling. Some of us are walking, and a few of us are running. We are still crawling. Some of us are walking, and few of us are running. For the original man is the invisible man in one sense. For he comes in spirit and in truth. And we walk by faith, not by sight. So sometimes people look out to look for the invisible man, and they look for him to be visible. But he is visible, but he's invisible. But he's visible by how you see him in spirit, by the acts that he performs and the deeds that he does, how he feeds the hungry, how he clothes the poor. The invisible man is visible through his actions and his deeds. That makes him a visible man, even though he may appear to be invisible to some. He is the original man, the invisible man, the spiritual man of the Holy Spirit, not of the spirit of death, not of the spirit of Satan. That man is dying out. And a new man is arriving on the scene. And by the grace of God, that spirit will become produced in many in the future. By the grace of God, that spirit will become produced in many in the future. The invisible man is becoming visible. And soon you will see the invisible man visibly visible. For those of you who cannot see, you will see the invisible man visibly visible. Figure that out for yourself. The invisible man will become visibly visible for all to see. For the rapture is at hand. For the rapture is at hand. So my brothers and my sisters, keep on giving out the light. Keep on giving out the light. We need to see. We need to be able to walk, we need to be able to talk, We need to be able to hear each other's voice and hear it out loud. For it's now no time to be silent, my brothers and my sisters. It's time to speak out. It's time for the invisible man to become visible, even though he is invisible. Let them see what you're made of. Let them see what you're made of. Let them see your makeup. You know how to create. You know how to produce. You know that you are not of this world, although you are in this world. You know that, my brothers and my sisters. You know you are not of this world, although you are in this world. And regardless of what they do on the outside, don't let them bring that on the inside of you. Regardless of what they're doing on the outside, don't let them bring that in the inside of you. For you have the invisible man walking inside of you, in spirit and in truth. And he teaches you what is right. Read your Bible. Continue to read your Bible. Continue to listen. Continue to go out and listen to the ministers. Continue to give support. Pay your dues when you go to church. You're supposed to pay your tithes. Pay your tithe. You know your 10%. Whatever your 10% is, take it and pay it. If you don't think that you can pay it every week, when you get your check, put it whatever you think is going to be for the month. Whatever your tithe is going to be for the month, take it down to ministry, give them that. Anything else you put in is just joy, just more, that's all. Make sure you pay your tithe. We need the money. And all the churches, they need the money. God needs his money. God needs the money. Pay your tithes to the church. Don't be tithing, be a tither. You pay tithes because you're a tither, not because you're tithing. Wherever you go, tithes are very important. I have learned that. They are very important to pay your tithes, whatever they may be. Pay it. Pay it. You'll have more by paying it than by not paying it. Regardless of how hard it looks, it ain't that hard that you can't pay your tithes. Pay your tithes, brothers and sisters. Pay them, pay them, pay them, pay them, pay them. That's all I got to say. Stay strong.